Hello, I'm Godfinger. Thank you for coming to my channel today. In this video, I'm going to try the Sonic Mini AKS, which is currently being released by Phrozen. I would like to thank you again for sending me the unreleased printer. Then, let's open it. The new color cab is first thing I see. The color is so pretty. Like Sonic Mini AK, it is much easier and simpler than when opening Mega AK. I'll check what is inside the box. Contains coupon from a 3D modeling site called Pixel. Sandpaper, stickers, wrench, power wire, chisel, and more are also included. Basic components including USB are prepared. So let's take a closer look at the printer. If you look at the back, there is a protective film attached like this, but I will remove this. I tighten this place more firmly with the 3mm screw here and then connect it. After laying the A4 paper below, I will perform Z-axis calibration. I hold it like this and tighten it with a screw one more time. Then the first preparation is complete. If you go to the Phrozen site, you can see the first Sonic Mini AKS promotional photo. You can buy it for $269.99 as a pre-order. If you look below, the specification of the Sonic Mini AKS are detailed. If you look at the bottom of the specifications, there is a table comparing Sonic Mini AK and Sonic Mini AKS. I set it up like this, just like the scene on the site. The biggest difference in appearance between the two prints is the color of the lid. The Sonic Mini AK has embossed mark detailed, but the AKS just feels like the mark is printed. The screen color is slightly different, but the menu is almost the same. Everything is the same as the Sonic Mini AKS, except for the language menu added. Now let's do the compatibility test. I'm going to change this screw once and put it on. They are the same, so they are compatible. I will change the VAT and try it on. It is also compatible. All four screws are the same. I'll see if the lid retracts. It doesn't matter if the lid is completely replaced. Another big difference is where the USB is plugged in. The Sonic Mini AKS USB port is on the left side, while the Sonic Mini AK's USB port is on the front. Sonic Mini AKS doesn't see the vent on the bottom. Sonic Mini AK has a vent on the back. So, Sonic Mini AK is very quiet when printing. There was hardly any noise, and the sensor is located on this side. The biggest difference is that the Sonic Mini AKS is one layer and the Sonic Mini AK is two layer. Looking upwards, both are sturdy and arch, although the Sonic Mini AK is thicker. The plate is also the same, so it's compatible. Of course, anyone wants change it on purpose, but I showed you that the side is the same. I compare the two prints like this, and I'm going to try printing in earnest. The resin to be used today is Phrozen Aqua-Gray AK resin. Let's print a cool Thanos with this resin and Sonic Mini AKS. It took about 4 hours. Like the name of the Sonic Mini AKS print, the size of the bed is mini, so it is not possible to print many parts at once. I printed the rest of the parts once again. I just pulled out a very small figure once. The details came out well. I'll trim the parts and assemble them. Thanos is complete. Thanos and small figures have been successfully printed with Sonic Mini AKS. This time I tried the newly released Sonic Mini AKS from Phrozen. The price is cheaper than Sonic Mini AK, but I think the output result is almost the same. If you make a purchase during the pre-order period this time, you can purchase it at a slightly cheaper price. So please take advantage of this opportunity. Then thank you for watching my video until the end today, and I will see you the next video. Thank you, I'm Godfinger.